you didn't know, my own personal laptop is a Microsoft Surface laptop, the first generation. It sports a 7th gen Intel Core i7, 8GB of RAM and 256GB of SSD storage. Really simple. But even so, it's been an amazing laptop and has served me well over the years, especially for things that I want to use it for, which are just mainly three things: web browsing, simple documents, and media consumption. But it's been quite a while, this is getting kind of old now. So today, I have the latest from Microsoft. This, the Surface Laptop 4. So, should I upgrade? To be very honest, even up to today and having reviewed quite a number of laptops, the Surface Laptop is arguably my favorite laptop. And it's with good reasons. First up, the design is clean and minimalistic, and it's been that way since the start. To be very frank, the design has withstood the test of time, and I still think it looks as fantastic today as it was a few years back, even when you consider the competition now. It has also since become somewhat of an iconic design as well. Thoroughly Microsoft. For the 15-inch Surface Laptop 4 that we have with us today, we have it in matte black, and the anodization of the aluminum is really well done. It just looks and feels great. But of course, it goes without saying that with enough use, you'll definitely be able to see it get dirty quite fast. If you want it to stay looking fresh even with heavy use, perhaps you might want to take a look at the Platinum instead. Now once you open it up, you'll be greeted with that Pixel Sense display. So of course, it's 15 inches, IPS, a resolution of 2496x1664 in a 3x2 aspect ratio, covers 100% sRGB, can get up to about 350 nits in brightness, and of course, supports touch. Now granted, the display is plenty great. It's sharp, it's vibrant, and you'll enjoy using it for pretty much anything you would use the laptop for, even photo editing. But it must be said that this panel is arguably the exact same panel that you'll find in the previous generation. And when you compare to the competition now, up against the likes of the XPS or the MacBook, it does fall short. I do wish that Microsoft had at least upgraded it to perhaps a maximum of 500 nits in brightness or cover a wider color spectrum like 100% Adobe RGB or 100% DCI-P 3. Well, it is what it is, but those upgrades would have made it a little bit more enticing and at least comparable to the current competition now. Though I have to say that the speakers are pretty great and they did catch me by surprise considering the form factor and the fact that there aren't any speaker grills. The sound sort of just comes from the keyboard deck itself, but it still does get plenty loud, and at least on the 15-inch model as compared to my old 13.5-inch, you can definitely hear more depth to the bass and a slightly wider soundstage. Overall, above average. Now you do also get a webcam up top, which does support Windows Hello. So, you're now looking at the webcam from the Surface Laptop 4, and as you can tell, it's 720p, with pretty okay colours and decent white balance. Microphones are, I would say, also pretty decent as well. But overall, it's just a 720p webcam and it's comparable to any other laptops with a 720p webcam. But the thing is this, the webcam on the Surface Laptop 4 is arguably the exact same webcam that you can find on my first generation Surface Laptop. And it kind of makes zero sense. It's been years, Microsoft, this deserves an upgrade. And it's made even weirder by the fact that the Surface Pro and the Surface Go, a much cheaper laptop or device, PC, have a better webcam than the Surface Laptop, which costs quite a lot more. Just take the webcam on those and slap it on here. Problem solved. Please do it, Microsoft. But now let's talk about the keyboard and trackpad. And I can say with utmost certainty that this feels amazing. The keys are pretty tactile and feel great to type on, and the entire typing experience is just really comfortable thanks to the extra space provided with a 3x2 aspect ratio. I do wish the backlight was a little bit stronger, however. The trackpad is also as great as ever and pretty much only second in the world. However, personally, I still very much prefer typing on my own Surface Laptop, and it's got everything to do with that Alcantara. This is such a unique experience and it's just so comfortable and so nice and so soft. The typing experience is really one of a kind, I have to say. Now, granted, you don't have the Alcantara option if you're taking a look at a 15-inch Surface Laptop 4, so yeah, it is what it is, but Alcantara. Simply awesome. As for ports, you basically get the proprietary Surface Connect, which is magnetic, and I honestly don't mind this port despite not a lot of people liking it. But aside from that, you also get a standard USB port, 3.5mm headphone mic combo jack, and a Type-C port. So, there aren't a lot of ports, especially for a 15-inch laptop, but it's made worse by the fact that Microsoft, for some reason or another, just don't want to include Thunderbolt 4 on that Type-C port. And this is true for the Intel Core model as well. So it's not because this is just running Ryzen. The Intel Core model doesn't get access to Thunderbolt 4 as well, which makes zero sense. We have been asking this for years, but Microsoft just don't want to do it. No idea why, it is what it is, but it's quite the huge bummer. Talking about battery life, you do get a 47Wh battery, and Microsoft claims to about 17 hours of usage, though in reality it's more around 9 or 10 hours. And for those of you who travel frequently, even from room to room, this laptop weighs just about 1.5 kg. But now, let's talk about specs and dive into the performance. Our unit runs an AMD Ryzen 7 4980U, 16GB of RAM and 512GB of PCIe SSD storage. This particular configuration will cost you just about 2400 Singapore dollars or about 1700 US dollars. In Cinebench R23, the Ryzen 7 4980U was able to score above 6000 on multi-core and about 1200 on the single core. As usual with AMD versus Intel, the Ryzen chip wins in terms of multi-core but loses in single core. In DaVinci Resolve, the Full HD 10-minute project took about 40 minutes to complete, while the 4K 15-minute project took about 1 hour and 10 minutes. Now, gaming. Light games like CSGO and Genshin Impact barely manage an average of even 30 frames per second, while AAA titles like Shadow of the Tomb Raider or Metro Exodus are pretty much unplayable, unless you drop to 720p with low settings. Not a great experience. As you can tell from the benchmarks, the performance isn't all that impressive, despite the Ryzen chip sporting 8 cores and 16 threads, and this is especially true for sustained workloads like rendering or gaming. Now, it's not that the Ryzen chip can't perform, it technically can, especially per spec and if this chip was in another laptop, but in this laptop, Microsoft has tuned it in favor of reduced noise levels and temperatures. Be it rendering in DaVinci Resolve or playing a game in Genshin, the Ryzen 7 constantly maintains a clock speed far lower than its base clock, which means, yes, temperatures never really exceed 70 degrees Celsius ever, and fan noise is really minimal, but performance simply takes a huge hit, and it really does show. So, do I feel like upgrading from this to that? Honestly, not really, and the reason for that is pretty simple. Even after 3 generations of Surface laptops, I just don't find it to be all that different, and the performance, while it's better, it's just not big enough of a performance jump for me to willingly upgrade without bat of an eyelid. Because I bought this laptop for really simple things like web browsing, basic documents, typing, media consumption. It's basically anything that any other laptop will be able to do. I do not need the extra horsepower that this offers. Now granted, the Surface Laptop 4 is a better laptop, but at the same time, it's also a weird laptop in the sense that there's so many things on there that's pretty much the same and can be found on this. The display, the webcam, the port selection, while it's a little bit better, it's still not much better. And honestly, the main difference is just the specifications alone. So I don't really need that extra horsepower, and yeah, it's just not much of an upgrade for me. But with all that said, I'm not saying that the Surface Laptop 4 is a bad laptop, because it's not. It's still great to use and I like it. But compared to the competition now, it just falls short on so many fronts. If you're looking to upgrade from a previous generation Surface Laptop, I would say don't. It's not worth it. It's not even worth it for me, coming from a first generation Surface Laptop. So if you have a Surface Laptop 2 or 3, not worth it. If you're looking at a new laptop, and you already know that you want a Surface Laptop 4 despite all that I've said, then, well, go for it. Honestly, it's still a great laptop, and you can arguably get really good prices for it thanks to educational discounts and whatnot. But just do take note of its shortcomings. All in all, the Surface Laptop 4 is a pretty great laptop, but against the competition, it's definitely below average. Personally, I still very much like it, and I might be biased because I already have a Surface Laptop myself, but even so, it's definitely not the upgrade for me, it's not worth it. But if I were to choose, I would still get the 13.5-inch Surface Laptop 4, and get the one with Alcantara. Alcantara makes all the difference. It's actually what I actually bought the laptop for, it's just because of Alcantara. But if that's it, this, okay, not the best. Look forward to the next one. Hopefully. Hopefully Microsoft fixes the next one. If you have any questions, let us know in the comment section down below. And if you'd like to, do check out the affiliate links in the description. If you do, thanks for the support. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to us on YouTube, follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Till the next one. See ya!